As the days grow shorter, and so does sunlight, you may be like many people who take vitamin D supplements.
I think it's good for me, but I feel like it does kind of give me a little bit of an energy level burst.
I'm actually originally from Alaska, so being, you know, long winters and whatnot, we kind of know that, you know, getting a little bit of boost kind of helps.
We know on average that people's vitamin D levels will dip during the winter. They'll go down. There's no convincing research suggesting that we need to prevent those dips in vitamin D levels.
Ian DeBoer is an epidemiologist at UW Medicine in Seattle. He studies how vitamin D deficiency affects kidney disease.
It's harder than you would think to define what is enough vitamin D. Vitamin D deficiency is based on blood measurements, specifically of a metabolite called 25-hydroxyvitamin D, and it is not clear how much of that is enough.
Vitamin D is important for bone health, especially for people with osteoporosis. If you have kidney disease, cystic fibrosis, certain gastrointestinal diseases, or had bypass surgery, you may need supplements.
The Institute of Medicine recommends that most people get at least 600 units of vitamin D a day. They do not recommend routine supplementation with vitamin D. They think people get enough from their diet already, and that doesn't include sun.
For most of us, even with less sun, foods fortified with vitamin D are an effective way to get a daily dose. From the UW Medicine Newsroom in Seattle, this is Megan Clark.